हेलो एवरीवन, कंटिन्यूइंग विद यूनिट 3 दैट इज फ्रिक्शन। इन दिस सेशन वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग अबाउट फ्रिक्शन इन कोनिकल पाइवेट बेयरिंग। एज इन द लास्ट सेशन वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट फ्रिक्शन इन फ्लैट पाइवेट बेयरिंग एंड वी हैव डिराइव्ड एन एक्सप्रेशन फॉर द फ्रिक्शनल टॉर्क ऑफ फ्लैट पाइवेट बेयरिंग कंसिडरिंग यूनिफॉर्म प्रेशर and second considering uniform wear. We have taken two assumptions, so based on uniform pressure and second based on uniform wear we have derived an expression for frictional torque in case of flat pivot bearing. So now let's consider a friction in conical pivot bearing. So consider this figure in which we have a shaft of radius r. We have a conical pivot bearing having cone angle 2 alpha as shown in figure. We have a radius of the shaft as capital R. An axial load of magnitude capital W is acting along the axis of the shaft, separating it into symmetrically into two halves, that is angle alpha on each side. We have say slant length L and normal to the slant pressure intensity as PN. So consider a small ring as we have assumed in last expression also. So we have a small ring of thickness dr at a distance small r from the center or of radius small r. So for the conical pivot bearing, let, as I just said, W is load transmitted over the bearing surface, that is along its axis. R is the radius of bearing surface. PN is intensity of pressure normal to the cone, and mu represents coefficient of friction. So from this figure we can see that alpha is a semi-cone angle, r is the radius and l is the slant height. So cosec alpha, which is 1 by sin alpha, can be written as l by r, or for this elementary ring cosec alpha could be dl by small dr. So consider the ring of radius r and thickness dr. Let DL is length of ring along the cone such that DL is equals to DR cosec alpha, as cosec alpha is DL by DR. So DL can be written as DR into cosec alpha, where DR is the thickness of the elementary ring. So therefore area of the ring would be 2 pi r dl, and dl can be written as dr cosec alpha. So area of the ring will be 2 pi r dr cosec alpha. Now we will consider the following two cases. First is when there is uniform pressure, and second is when there is uniform wear. So let's start with when there is a uniform pressure on a conical pivot bearing. So as in the previous discussion also, we'll have the same kind of derivation for conical pivot bearing. So consider a ring of radius r and thickness dr. Let dl be the length of the ring along the cone. So area of the ring, as we have just discussed, 2 pi r dl, and dl can be written as dr cosec alpha. So area of the ring will be 2 pi r dr cosec alpha. Clear? We know that normal load acting on the ring, this normal load will be normal to the slant height. I'll explain it in a much better way. So this normal load acting on the ring will be normal force acting on the ring, that is Pn into area of the ring. that is Pn into 2 pi r dr cosec alpha. This del Wn will be, as you can see here, Pn is normal to this slant, so del Wn will be perpendicular to the slant, that is parallel to the direction of intensity of pressure Pn, which is also normal to the slant of the cone. Let me make it more clear. Consider that this is a cone which is symmetrical about its axis, having 2 alpha as the cone angle, that is alpha on each side. So we have a load capital W which is acting along the axis of the cone. Considering the small area where the normal pressure Pn is acting along the surface of the cone, so we have del Wn, that is normal load acting to this ring which is perpendicular to this slant. Let me draw a vertical line. So this del Wn will be perpendicular to the slant, so it will be at an angle of, say this angle is alpha, as this cone, half cone angle is alpha, and we have drawn a vertical line. So this vertical line and this axis line is parallel, so they are vertically opposite angle. So this is alpha, so this angle will be 90 minus alpha, as from the line of normal load to this slant surface it is 90. This is alpha, so this will also be alpha, so the angle of normal load to the vertical will be 90 minus alpha. Clear? So this force which is vertically downward, that is dw, will be how much? Dwn sin alpha, because it will be dwn cos 90 minus alpha, and cos 90 minus alpha will be sin alpha. Clear? So we have taken a normal load acting to the ring as dwn, but vertical load acting to the ring will be dwn sin alpha, which will be equals to Pn into 2 pi r dr cosec alpha into sin alpha. Cosec alpha is 1 upon sin alpha, so this vertical load acting to the ring will become 2 pi r dr into Pn. Cosec alpha and sin alpha cancelling each other. Clear? So what we have taken is, we have taken an elementary ring, then we have taken a normal load which will be pressure into area, then we have taken a vertical load by, with the help of say trigonometric equation or geometry. Now total vertical load transmitted to bearing will be the integration of this del W from 0 to R. So W will be equals to Pn into pi r square, or we can write Pn as W upon pi r square, as we have done in the flat pivot bearing case also. But here the concept is, the normal load is normal to slant, and we are taking the vertical load, because total vertical load is W, so a small portion of is del W, which is vertical in direction. So now frictional resistance to sliding on the ring acting tangentially at radius r will be, frictional resistance is normal load into mu, that is coefficient of friction. So along this elementary ring, Fr will be mu into del Wn, that is mu into del Wn is Pn into 2 pi r dr cosec alpha. In the same way, frictional torque will be frictional resistance into R, so it will be 2 pi mu Pn r dr cosec alpha into r. So it becomes 2 pi mu pn r into r, r square cosec alpha dr. Total frictional torque will be integrating this equation within the limits from 0 to r for the total frictional torque on the conical pivot bearing. We will get 0 to r 2 pi mu pn r square cosec alpha dr. In this expression, 2 is constant, pi is constant, mu is constant, pressure is also constant, cosec alpha is also constant. So integration of r square dr will be r cube by 3, and on solving we'll get 2 by 3 pi mu p pn r cube cosec alpha. So upon integrating we'll get total frictional torque as 2 by 3 pi mu pn r cube cosec alpha. Now put value of pn as w upon pi r square, we'll get, so again putting value of pn, that is w upon pi r square, we get t is equals to 2 by 3 mu w r cosec alpha, where mu is coefficient of friction, w is axial load, r is the radius of shaft, and alpha is the semicon angle. Also r cosec alpha can be written as l, so we can write t is equals to 2 by 3 mu w l. Yes, now we get the value of t, that is the total frictional torque. So we can calculate power also. So when the shaft is rotating at omega radian per second, then power lost in friction will be T omega, and omega can be written as 2 pi n by 60. So power lost in friction will be 2 pi n t by 60, and considering uniform pressure, the frictional torque is 2 by 3 mu w l, or 2 by 3 mu w r cosec alpha. And here power loss in friction is 2 pi nt by 60, where n is in rpm, that is the speed of shaft in rpm. So next will be considering uniform wear. So considering uniform wear, we know that the product of intensity of pressure into radius is constant, or we can write Pn is equals to C by R. Same as we did, consider a ring of radius R and thickness dr. Let dl be the length of the ring along the cone. Area of the ring will be 2 pi r dl, and in place of dl we can write 2 pi r dr cosec alpha. Now load acting to the ring will be pressure into area, that is normal pressure into area. So del wn will be pn into a, that is pn into 2 pi r dr cosec alpha. As in the previous derivation also, we'll take a vertical load acting to the ring will be dwn sin alpha. So it will become pn into 2 pi r dr cosec alpha into sin alpha. This sin alpha and cos alpha will cancel each other. We'll get vertical load acting to the ring as 2 pi r dr into pn, or pn into 2 pi r dr. Integrating it from 0 to r, total vertical load transmitted to bearing will be 0 to r pn 2 pi r dr, and in place of pn from here we can write c by r. Cancel this r with this r, we'll get integration from 0 to r c 2 pi dr. So integration of dr will be r. So c will become equals to w upon 2 pi r. Let it be equation 1. Second, and equation 1 was normal load acting on to the ring. Now we get the value of c as w upon 2 pi r, where c is a constant while considering uniform wear, that is a product of p into r. Now frictional resistance to sliding will be mu into normal load, that is mu into del wn. Put the value, we'll get frictional resistance as 2 pi mu pn r dr cosec alpha. Frictional torque on the ring will be frictional force or frictional resistance into r, that is fr into r. So it becomes 2 pi mu pn r dr cosec alpha into r. So it becomes 2 pi mu pn r square dr cosec alpha. Put the value of pn. Finally we get frictional torque on the ring as 2 pi mu r cosec alpha dr. Now for the total frictional resistance, or we can say for the total frictional torque, we will be integrating the previous or the equation within the limits from 0 to r, that is total frictional torque will be 0 to r 2 pi mu c r cosec alpha dr. Here 2 is constant, pi and mu are constant, c is constant, cosec alpha is constant. So integration of r dr will be r square by 2 to cancel. So we get total frictional torque as 2 pi, sorry, pi mu c r square cosec alpha. Put this value of c as w upon 2 pi r from equation second. We get the total frictional torque for a conical pivot bearing considering uniform wear as 1 by 2 mu w r cosec alpha, or we can write 1 by 2 mu w l, as l is equals to r cosec alpha. So total frictional torque is 1 by 2 mu w l, as l is equals to r cosec alpha, where l is the slant height of the cone, r is the radius of the cone, mu is the coefficient of friction, and w represents the axial load acting on the shaft. So considering uniform wear in a conical pivot bearing, total frictional torque is T is equals to 1 by 2 mu w r cosec alpha. And in the same way, we can calculate the power lost in friction if we know the speed with which the shaft is rotating. So when the shaft rotates at omega radian per second, then power lost in friction will be torque into omega. So that will be 2 pi nt by 60, where n is the speed of the shaft in rpm. So we have derived an expression for total frictional torque in case of a conical pivot bearing with the two different assumptions separately, that is considering uniform pressure and considering uniform wear. Hope you are clear. So for more videos, you can subscribe to my YouTube channel, that is Gagan Bansal. Or for any query, you can directly mail me at gaganbansal12345@gmail.com or gaganbansal@gu.ac.in. Thank you so much.